next caller is. Hello everyone. I am Aisha Patel of class 7C. Now I am going to deliver my opinion regarding the topic Swachh Bharat. Cleanliness will not come with brooms in hand, but by understanding it as a responsibility of every citizen. On the occasion of the Gandhi Jayanti 2 October, our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji has launched the new mission, that was the Swachh Bharat mission. Swachh Bharat mission has given us a clear message to keep our surrounding neat, clean and green. Recently, our Honorable Prime Minister has also inaugurated the Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra. While inaugurating the Rashtriya Swachhata Kendra, the Prime Minister has given us a new slogan, that is Gandagi Bharat Chodo. So by saying this, you should also contribute in the construction of the new India, that would be a neat, clean and green India. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.
My name is Mukul Nirman. I am from class 7D. Today I am going to tell about the benefits of the virtual classes. As we all know, there is the disease that spread all over the world, that names COVID-19. People are suffering from a very hard time. So the government has locked many public places like temples, offices, industries and many other places, and especially the schools, which are very useful for the children. And this is the major problem for all the students to attend their all regular classes. So the schools are started the online virtual classes. The benefits of online virtual classes are, this is the best way to clear the concepts at home. We can clear our concepts and to our teachers face to face. But there is the negative effects of the online virtual classes, that are some parents cannot afford the mobile phone for his children. And some students can't attempt their classes due to their network issue. So we can take the major few steps to improve the online studies. Thank you.
Good morning everyone. I am Sandhya from class 7C. Today I speak about why computer is important in our everyday life. Computer is important in our everyday life because it is very much accurate and fast. It can do very big calculation in just few seconds and also store a huge amount of data in it. Computer is useful in schools, hospitals, banks and also useful in making movies, pictures, shows, etc. We can send email faster across a universe, and we also know everything which is happening in the world. We stay connected with our friends and family with the help of internet on computer. Computer provide us information and also entertain us, like movies, pictures, show, cartoons, etc. Computer is the best.
Kapoor of class 7D. Today I am going to speak on the topic air pollution. Firstly, we have to discuss what is air pollution. Air pollution refers to any physical, chemical or biological change in the air. It is a contamination of air by harmful gases, dust and smoke, which affects the plants, animals and humans drastically. Now, some common air pollutants are methane, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide, etc. Now, we have to discuss what causes air pollution. Excessive use of chemical and synthetic products, agricultural activities, open burning of garbage waste, emissions from transports, excessive burning of fossil fuels, forest fires and industrial emissions are some major causes of air pollution. effects of air pollution, mortality, cardiovascular diseases, global warming, acid rain, depletion of the ozone layer, loss of wildlife, effects on agriculture, cancer, lung diseases, economic effects, and many more. Every problem has a solution. So, we can solve this problem by following some preventive measures. Use public transport. Turn off the lights when not in use. Follow 3 R's, that is, reduce, reuse and recycle. Say no to plastic bags. Use fans instead of air conditioner. Implement afforestation. Avoid usage of crackers. Use solar energy. Air pollution is not a joke. Air pollution will make you choke. So at the last but not the least, I would like to say that be a part of a solution, not pollution. Thank you. I hope you will make my words meaningful.
My name is Tejal Khanna. I am from class 7C. My topic is water pollution. Water is most important natural resource of life. Human beings need water not only for drinking but also for cooking, fishing, etc. People have been misusing water since long. Industrial waste, garbage and other remaining of huge commodities have been getting dumped in river and ocean, causing contaminated of water. It is also contaminated of toxic chemical discharge from factories, pesticides used in agriculture and so on. Due to poor water supply, system contacts sewage with the water supply line, contaminate water used for drinking. Contaminated water has become a threat to human beings, fish and the animals. The poor and less developed countries facing greater problem of water pollution and supply system also lacking proper wastage of disposable system. Thanks.
Good evening, ma'am. My name is Ritika Sharma. I am from class 70. I am hereby present to share my views on boycott of China products. As we all can see the condition going on through nowadays, this pandemic has lowered our economy and crisis due to which many people lost their jobs. But the China is viewing as opportunity and trying to trade all the major markets around world. But not only this, on the other side, China is also trying to snatch our loans by showing its military power. But if we continuously buying their products, then we should provide this capital to China, and by using this capital, they are going on to attack on us. As a concerned citizen, it is our duty to should not buy their products and don't give them what they want and should boycott China products. Thank you.
My name is Kavya. I read in class 7th D, and my topic is plastic bags should be banned. Plastic is non-biodegradable and thus causes pollution as it cannot be recycled. Burning plastic diffuses harmful smoke. Plastic bag can prove a choke hazard for small animals and people. Plastic water bottles are also thought to be carcinogenic. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. My name is Abhinav Sharma, class 7C, roll number 1. My topic is street light. A street light illuminating a road typically mounted on the tall post. When there is a need of light on road, automatically switches on when darkness rises. To contain level, then sensor is activated and switches on when there is a other source of light. Example, daytime the street light get off. The sensitiveness of the street light can also adjust. So when the light shines on the photocell, it turns the transistor on, the which energy is the relay entanglement which turn the light off when it is dark, photocell has high resistance, so no current flow through the base and the relay is not activated. The light on the tele high indicator street lighting provided a number of important benefits. It can be also promoted security in urban areas to increase a quality of life by artificially expanded the hours in which it is the light so that activity can take place. Street lighting also improves safety for driver, rider and pedestrians. Thanks, ma'am.
One of my old teachers and my friends, as we all knew that that money lost can be earned again, but the time once lost cannot be recovered. Today's life has become so fast and competitive that one has to take great care of time. Loss of 1 second can cost you more. There are only 24 hours in a day. Every day, everybody has to finish their work within this time frame by analyzing every second properly. If we talk about students, then they have to do all their homework, chapter revisions and preparations within 24 hours. A student who knows the importance of time can never fail in his entire life. He can succeed through his discipline and time management. For making students successful, their parents and teachers can help them to make their routine, which will help them to manage their efficiently the best way to avoid the tendency of being late and completing task on time is time management. The first thing to manage time is to set our goals. Once the goal is set, we have to completely focus on it without wasting any time. Next thing in time management is two priorities and keeping the importance one on high priority. Always finish your allocated tasks first and then only try to help others. Thank you.
Hello, respected teachers and my dear friends. I'm Harshita of class 7C and today I express my views in the new education policy. As we all know that the Union Cabinet approved the new education policy on 29th of July. The good news is that the new policy has come with many changes that have been necessary for a long time now. The policy states our mother language, regional or local language is to be medium of instructions in all school up to 5th class to learn their own language better. The policy has also removed the system of pick the stream in class 11. In a new multidisciplinary method, one can pick psychology and arts if they desire so. It will engage children in extracurricular activities and sports, and it will take immense burden off the shoulders of children. In the last, I will say that the new education policy is good for every student. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.
Good morning, teachers and my dear friends. I am Devansh Dhandyal of class 7D. My topic is child labor. Child labor is one of the most significant issue to block the social and economical growth of the nation. It is illegal because the age of 5 to 15 are not yet ready to work. We all know that children become the future of our country. So why the people are using child labor only for their small benefits? Child labor withdrawn small children from their sweet and memorable childhood. It interferes with their regular schooling as it disturbs them mentally, physically, socially and morally. According to International Labour Organization, 33 million children in India alone are engaged in the practice of child labor, poverty, debt, illiteracy, corruption, poor implementation of schemes and laws, etc. are some reasons of child labor became the permanent problem. I would like to conclude my speech requesting you to all to keep the fight against child labor. If we witness child exploitation in any form, the future of nation release its children. If the child suffering today, then our nation suffering tomorrow. Thank you.
Hello friends and respected teacher. My name is Anshuman Gupta from class 7C of Rukmani Devi Jaipuria Public School. Today my topic is natural resources. A natural resource is something that is found in nature and can be used by people. Earth's natural resources include light, air, water, plant, animal, soil, stone, mineral and fossil fuel. People need some natural resources to stay alive. They use other to make their life better. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am and my dear friends. My name is Mahir Khan from 7C. I am telling about importance of hard work. Hard work is the only key to achieving success. Hard work teaches us discipline, dedicates to do any work. This is a first step towards smart work. We gain experience. It helps us discover many new things. To achieve anything in life, one has to commit to continue hard work. Smart work is a fruit of hard work. So my friends, do hard work and get success in our life. Thank you.
Or sir, my name is Zainul Abidin and I am from class 7B and my topic is education during COVID-19. Due to the current situation of the world, all schools, colleges and universities are closed because of COVID-19 pandemic. As everyone knows, the education are not going on, so the government started the online education during this situation. This is good in the outbreak of COVID-19. Real change often take place in deep crisis, and this moment holds the possibility that won't return to the status quo when things return to the normal. While has deeply disruptive implications for education, it does not have predetermined implication. Thank you.
Good morning everyone, my name is Arshit Mishra, I am from class 7D. Today I am going to talk about fundamental rights and its characteristics. So there are some basic rights that are very well known as fundamental rights to human's existence. In the absence of fundamental rights, the man's existence would be worthless. So the political institution role and responsibility mainly emphasized on empowering the people, especially the minorities, to live in dignity with the right of equality, dignity and religious freedom. We totally have 7 fundamental rights. First, right to equality. Nobody can judge you because of your color, caste, religion, etc. Second, right to freedom. In this right, you have freedom of speech, profession and you can move freely. Third, right to exploitation. Nobody can harass you in the name of human trafficking and forced labor. Fourth, right to freedom of religion. Nobody can force you to adopt a particular religion. Every person has a right to adopt the religion of his choice. Fifth, cultural and educational right. In this right, you have a choice to protect your culture, religion, language, tradition, and have education institution to promote your culture. Sixth, right to constitutional remedy. This is a very special right. According to that right, citizen is who denied
the fundamental right can approach the Supreme Court. It is the soul of the Constitution. Seventh right to privacy. This is the latest right added in 2017. In this right, every citizen has a right to privacy. Privacy invasions are punishable. Conclusion. Finally, the conclusion is the fundamental right plays a very important role in citizens' life. Thank you.
My dear friends, my name is Akash Kumar, class 7C. I have been speaking the safety paragraph. I am speaking. Out of all the elements found on this planet, three account for the susceptibility of the large population portion of the environment occupying waste extend to land in forest, hits natural parks and wildlife for centuries. Trees purify the atmosphere where oxygen. All forms of life depend on their direct and indirect needs on the records provided by trees. Large industries and organization drive their law. The material in the flower in the form of wood, paper, fiber, timber obtained the trees. Save tree, save a life. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Good morning. My topic is importance of education. Education is very important tool for everyone to succeed in life and get something different. It helps a lot in lessening the challenges of life difficult. Knowledge gained throughout the education period enables each and every individual confident about their life. It opens various doors for the opportunities of achieving better prospects in life, so promotes career growth. Many awareness programs has been run by the government in rural areas. It brings feeling of equality among all people in the society and promotes growth and development of the country. Thank you.
Hello everybody, my name is Prakhar Vadva. I study in 7th class. My topic is unemployment. Unemployment is a situation when a person does not have paid job but seeking one. Unemployment mostly occurs to a certain age group of 15 to 16 years or 60 to 65 years. Most growth of population is the one of the leading factors of unemployment. Unemployment growth whose look after accomplished towards unemployment.